Hi, myself Professor J.J. Auguste. I am delivering lecture on robots and its applications. So in this video, I am covering the topics, basic elements of a robot, robot joints and robot configurations. A robot is a general purpose programmable machine possessing certain characteristics. A robot is a reprogrammable multifunctional manipulator. The main characteristics of an industrial robot is its mechanical arm, which is used to perform various industrial tasks. Other human-like characteristics are the robot's capabilities to respond to sensory inputs, communicates with other machines, and make decisions. These capabilities permit robots to perform a variety of useful tasks. It is designed to move materials, parts, tools, or specialized devices through variable program motions for the performance of a variety of tasks. Some of the qualities make industrial robots commercially and technologically important are: first, robots can be substituted for humans in hazardous or uncomfortable work environments. Second, a robot performs its work cycle with a consistency and repeatability that cannot be attained by humans. Third, robots can be reprogrammed for another task. Fourth, robots are controlled by computers and can therefore be connected to other computer systems to achieve computer-integrated manufacturing. The basic elements of a robot are mechanical platform, the hardware base, sensors, motors, driving mechanisms, power supplies, electronic controls, microcontroller systems and languages. Now we will see the key components of a robot. First component, manipulator. It is mainly consist of a base, an arm and wrist. Robots are mounted on a base which is fastened to the floor. The body is attached to the base and the arm assembly is attached to the body. At the end of the arm is the wrist. The wrist consists of a number of components that allows it to be oriented in a variety of positions. Second component, controller. It is the brain of the robot and is based on a computer. Its major functions are to store, to sequence, and to position the data in memory, and to initiate, stop, and control motions of manipulator as per instructions given. The controller has two components, the hardware and software. Third component or the element is end effectors. Robot's wrist is attached by a hand. The technical name for the hand is end effector. It is a tool which is directly interacts with the job. Depending on the type of work, the end effector may be a gripper, torch or welding torch, etc. Next element is a sensors. For robots, sensing as well as its interaction with the environment is essential. Different types of sensors can be incorporated. Next element is energy source. Depending upon the load, electrical, hydraulic, pneumatic energy source is used for movement of manipulator. The next part is robot joints. So mechanical joints of the robot can be classified into one of the five types, two types that provide translational motion and the three types that provide rotary motion. Translational motion includes the linear joint and orthogonal joint, and rotary motion includes rotational joint, twisting joint and revolving joint. So first, linear joint. In this, the relative movement between the input link and the output link is a translational sliding motion, with the axis of the two links are parallel. This is also called type L joint. The second joint is orthogonal joint. This is also called type O joint. This is also a translational sliding motion, but the input and the output links are perpendicular to each other during the move. The third joint is rotational joint. This is also called type R joint. This type provides rotational relative motion with the axis of rotation perpendicular to the axis of the input and the output link. The number 4 is twisting joint. This is also called type T joint. This joint also involves rotary motion, but the axis of rotation is parallel to the axis of two links. The last joint is revolving joint. This is also called type V joint. In this, the axis of the input link is parallel to the axis of rotation of the joint, and the axis of output link is perpendicular to the axis of rotation of the joint. Now the next part is robot configuration. There are two categories of the robot configuration: A, body and arm configuration, and B, wrist configuration. A, body and arm configuration includes polar configuration, cylindrical configuration, Cartesian configuration, jointed arm configuration, and SCARA configuration. So first, polar configuration. This configuration consists of a sliding arm, L joint, actuated relative to the body, which can rotate about both a vertical axis and a horizontal axis. Second, cylindrical configuration. The robot configuration consists of a vertical column relative to which an arm assembly is moved up and down. The arm can be moved in and out relative to the axis of the column. Using a T joint can rotate the column about its axis. L joint is used to move the arm assembly vertically along the column, while O joint is used to achieve radial movement of the arm. The third type is Cartesian coordinate robot. The other name for this configuration include rectilinear robot and XYZ robot. It is composed of three sliding joints, two of which are orthogonal. Next type of joint is jointed arm robot. This robot manipulator has the general configuration of the human arm. The jointed arm consists of a vertical column that swivels about the base using a T joint. At the top of the column is a shoulder joint whose output link connects to an elbow joint. Then the SCARA. SCARA is for selective compliance assembly robot arm. This configuration is similar to the jointed arm robot, except that the shoulder and elbow rotational axis are vertical, which means that the arm is very rigid in the vertical direction but compliant in the horizontal direction. This permits the robot to perform insertion task for assembly in a vertical direction, where some slight to side to side alignment may be needed to make the two parts properly. The part B of the robot configuration is the wrist configuration. The robot's wrist is used to establish the orientation of the end effector. Robot wrist usually consists of 2 or 3 degrees of freedom. The three joints used in a 3 degrees of freedom wrist assembly are: first is roll, using a T joint to accomplish rotation about the robot's arm axis. Second, pitch, which involves up and down rotation, typically using R joint. And third, it is yaw, which involves right and left rotation, also accomplished by means of the R joint. A 2 degrees of freedom wrist typically includes only roll and pitch joints. Thank you.